Before proceeding, please make sure to subscribe and turn on the bell icon for upcoming videos. Today's video is about sialorrhea. Sialorrhea or hypersalivation, also called ptyalism, is an excessive production or presence of saliva in the oral cavity that may cause unintentional loss of saliva from the mouth or drooling of a person. Before moving on with sialorrhea, let's look at the contribution of the major salivary glands in saliva production and their nerve supply. We know that humans have three pairs of major salivary glands, which are the parotid gland, the submandibular gland, and the sublingual gland. The parotid gland accounts for 20% of saliva production. The sublingual gland accounts for 7-8% of saliva production. And the submandibular gland accounts for the greatest amount of saliva production, which is about 65-70%. The submandibular and sublingual glands are innervated by the facial nerve through the superior salivary nucleus in the pons and synapsing in the submandibular ganglion. The parotid gland is innervated by the glossopharyngeal nerve through the inferior salivary nucleus in the medulla and synapsing in the otic ganglion. Remember here that these two nerves will bring the parasympathetic innervation to these glands. And we know that the parasympathetic nerves are cholinergic, or they will release acetylcholine at the neuroglandular junction. Now let's come to some causes of sialorrhea. As we said earlier that sialorrhea is an excessive production or presence of saliva in the oral cavity, so it may be either a result of an increase in saliva production or a decrease in salivary clearance. The saliva production may be increased due to certain parasympathomimetic or cholinergic drugs like acetylcholine, methanicol, or pilocarpine. Antipsychotic drugs like clozapine also have autonomic effects and they might increase saliva production. GERD or gastroesophageal reflex disease can also stimulate saliva production. Saliva production in GERD is a protective buffering response to acids encountered in the oral cavity. Enemas present in the CNS can also stimulate saliva production. Decrease in salivary clearance may be due to a loss in neuromuscular control and some other irritations in the oral cavity, resulting in difficulties in swallowing of a person, causing accumulation of saliva in the oral cavity. Decrease in salivary clearance due to loss of neuromuscular control is encountered in amyotrophic lateral sclerosis, Parkinson's disease, and other neuromuscular disorders. Chronic nausea can also cause a decrease in salivary clearance. Ill-fitting dentures and aphthous ulcers can also cause a decrease in salivary clearance due to difficulties in swallowing. Let's look at some clinical features of sialorrhea. The main clinical feature of sialorrhea is drooling. Excessive presence of saliva in the oral cavity can cause aspiration of saliva, resulting in aspiration pneumonia. Traumatic ulcers and choking due to obstruction of airway can also be observed. Perioral irritation and malodor can also be a consequence of sialorrhea. Depending on etiology, there are several categories of treatment for sialorrhea. If the problem is in the neuromuscular control, physical therapy can prove to be helpful. Medications are also helpful. The medications most often used are the anticholinergics, like atropine. In severe cases, surgeries could also be performed, like ductal relocation surgery, where the submandibular duct is relocated posteriorly. Resection of part of the submandibular gland can also be helpful. Radiation therapy can also be used for elderly patients who are not candidates for surgery or other medical therapy. In addition, botulinum toxin has also proven to be effective in treating sialorrhea. It works by reversibly blocking the presynaptic release of acetylcholine at the neuroglandular junction. If you think this video was helpful, please like, subscribe, share, and comment if you have any questions. Thank you for watching.